Good afternoon. Thanks for joining us here at Georgia Highlands College for this exciting announcement. Lately, most of the things that I've been involved in terms of announcements, haven't been quite as exciting as I would have liked to. We've been announcing tuition increases or these kinds of things. So this is one of the really fun parts of this job. That hadn't been all that fun recently is announcing the new athletic program. Yesterday the Board of Regents approved our allocation, our tuition and fee package, and as part of that was included a new athletic fee that we will start collecting next fall of 2011. Almost immediately, we'll join the Georgia College Athletic Association, which is part of the National Junior College Athletic Association. We will also begin very soon searching for a full-time athletics director. By next fall 2012, we anticipate playing competitive men's and women's sports here at Georgia Highlands College. At this point, what we think is going to happen is that we will start with men's and women's basketball, and we will probably add two competitive sports a year every year after that. The reason basketball has been chosen is fairly obvious in that we already have a facility that will accommodate men's and women's collegiate basketball. Right now we plan to begin, again as I said, with basketball, and it will be here. After that, we will of course continue our feasibility studies and continue to look at what sports we would bring on after that. We of course hope to bring on baseball and softball, men's and women's soccer, men's and women's tennis, and others. As you know, Title IX requires, and the NCAA and the NCJCA requires us to have competitive sports that mirror the population of our institution. Georgia Highlands College, like most two-year and a lot of four-year colleges today, is about a 60-40 split between men and women. So it's probably going to be a situation where you'll see more women's sports actually than men, at least in the beginning. Here, let me tell you a little bit about how we got to this point. We have, of course, been looking and thinking about this because our students have been thinking about this and coming to us and asking, you know, when are we going to have competitive sports here at Georgia Highlands College? So a little over a year ago, Dr. Ron Shea and David Mathis put together an athletic study committee to look at the feasibility of bringing intercollegiate athletics to Georgia Highlands College. We involved our students. We involved consultants. We involved our community. Many of our community forum participants who we brought in to talk about the idea of athletics is sitting here with us today, as are members of our foundation, Georgia Highlands College Foundation. So we believe that we've involved virtually every constituent that's involved in Georgia Highlands College in this process. The students overwhelmingly, approximately 80% of the students polled said that they were in favor and did want us to bring athletics to Georgia Highlands College, and over 60% were willing to pay for us to be able to do that. We did form an athletic study committee, as I indicated, and brought in members of the community to help us do that. And it's fallen into place very nicely since that study was completed. Aside from joining the GCAA and beginning the search for an athletics director, we will also immediately begin recruiting our coaches and our student athletes. We did make this decision in the middle of a budget crunch, and again, a lot of questions were directed at me about how can we talk about doing some of these things in the middle of a recession, in the middle of budget crunches that higher education finds itself today. And quite frankly, the answer to that has been we have to be able to compete for students at all levels, and we have to be able to compete for students just like other colleges, the technical colleges and the four-year colleges are doing. What we know is that student athletes bring a good record in terms of their retention and graduation rates to the process and to our student body, and we feel like that this is going to be an addition that is going to overall and in the long run be very beneficial and certainly very beneficial to the institution. With that, we have redesigned, as you see, the logos a little bit. We'll have variations for the athletic logos. We are the Chargers, and that's a horse if you did know that. In medieval times, as a matter of fact. And we will be the Chargers going forward. Our colors, as you can see, are blue and orange. David tried to get me to duplicate the Boise State logo, and I told him I'm sure there would be copyright problems with doing that. So we are the Chargers, and with that, I want to bring on our mascot, Bolt. Dana asked that Bolt have a basketball and go shoot a few for us, and everybody else said, no, please, don't let him shoot the basketball, he's terrible. And, so he's just here to hold the basketball, not to shoot it. All right, Bolt, you good? Behave yourself. At this point, I just want to open it up for questions. Any questions that I can answer for you at this time? If you're part of the media, obviously, Dana's giving you press packages, but I'll be glad to answer any questions that you have for us at this point in time. The first game would be, depending on whether how fast we get the athletic director in place and coaches in place. We have actually contemplated and talked about playing the first season, actually, maybe even as early as next year, next fall and winter, playing basketball. It would be at the club level. We compete with other institutions, but we would not be able to participate in any of the playoffs. So it really, Tommy, depends on how fast we're able to get the infrastructure, athletic director, coaches, and all in place. If not, then we will certainly have all of that in place in time for basketball coaches to start recruiting next year's senior crop coming out of high school. Well, all the communities we serve have certainly been very, very supportive in terms of the process of vetting this with them, of talking about the possibilities and everything. As you also know, The Rome community, the Bartow community are huge supporters of high school and intercollegiate athletics. We have four colleges here, all of them, including Georgia Northwestern Technical College, are playing college athletics now. Of course, this venue actually is one of the host venues for the Rome News Tribune Christmas tournament. And of course, we also host the regional basketball tournament here in this facility. So this is a very appropriate and likely starting point for this athletic program. But we also realize that all of our other communities have very competitive and supportive athletic communities. And so we look forward to bringing, like we said, baseball, softball, and some of the other sports to the other communities as well. Is that it? Well, again, thank you all. We're very excited about this as a possibility. We think that our students are really going to enjoy this as part of their college, their collegiate careers, and we think that this is important to the development and the future development of this institution as it continues to evolve as an institution. And we think that this is, the timing is right. It's never perfect, but we think the timing is right. We think we have done our homework in terms of the feasibility study, in terms of vetting this with our communities, and we're very excited about starting to play in collegiate athletics. So thank you.